Good day, class. Hope you all good. Let's have a look at a quote. Enjoy the little things, for one day you may look back and realize they were the big things. Enjoy the little things, for one day you may look back and realize they were the big things. By Robert Brault. Childhood is one of the amazing colorful period in each one of our life. As school students, now you try to make awesome memories in this period, cause one day when you grown up and move into the busy and stressful world, suddenly in one point we think about our life, these childhood memories will delight us with smile. So try to make awesome memories now. For today's class, we're going to see a prose, "I Can't Climb Trees Anymore," written by Ruskin Bond. "I Can't Climb Trees Anymore," written by Ruskin Bond. This prose work deals with the childhood memories of the author. We can call this prose as autobiography of Ruskin Bond, cause he talks about his life in this prose. First, let's see about the author. Ruskin Bond was born on May 19, 1934. He is an Indian author of British descent. That is, he was the son of Anglo-Indian parents. He is much known as children literature writer in India. He received the following awards. He got the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992, Padma Shri in 1999, Padma Bhushan in 2014. Please note down, Sahitya Academy Award in 1992, Padma Shri in 1999, Padma Bhushan in 2014. As a prolific writer, he has written over 500 short stories, essays and novels. Now let's move on to the prose work. I Can't Climb Trees Anymore. First, I share the short summary of the prose. Listen carefully. This prose work was underlined a very basic theme of human lives, that is, searching the memories of old days by going back to the place of childhood and finding those people who once were part of the author's life. In present, the author was living in England and become very better writer. From there, he recollects all his childhood memories and taking a journey to see all the places where he spent his childhood, and later he found the changes that take place over there and become very sad. Okay, students, now let's see the prose work paragraph after paragraph. Let's see first paragraph. He stood on the grass verge by the side of the road and looked over the garden wall at the old house. It had not changed much. The old house, built with a solid block of granite, was not altered at all. There was a new outhouse and there were fewer trees. He was glad to see that the jackfruit tree still stood at the side of the building, casting its shade on the wall. First, let's see the meaning for the hard word in this paragraph. He stood on the grass verge. Verge, meaning for verge is edge. Now let me explain. The author is standing on the edge of the grass field and looking over the garden wall of the old house. The old house was built with solid blocks of granite and it was not altered at all. And also, he saw a new house near the old house. The author is happy to see a jackfruit tree that stands near the new house. The author was extremely happy to see the shadow of the jackfruit tree falls on the new house. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. He remembered his grandmother saying, "A blessings rest on the house where the shadow of a tree falls." And so the present owners must also be receiving the tree's blessings. At the spot where he stood, there had once been a turnstile. And as a boy, he would swing on it, going round and round until he was quite dizzy. Now the turnstile was gone, the opening wall up, tall hollyhocks grown on the other side of the wall. Now let's see the hard words. Turnstile. The word turnstile means a mechanical gate which revolves. A mechanical gate which revolves. Next, hollyhocks. Hollyhocks means a tall Eurasian plant. It's a plant species. A tall Eurasian plant. Now I will explain. Here, the author remembers his grandmother saying, "A blessings rest on the house where the shadow of a trees fall." So the author think the present owner of the house must be blessed because the jackfruit tree's shadow falling on the walls of the new house. Then at that spot where the author is sitting where once be a turnstile. I hope you remember the meaning for turnstile. A mechanical gate which revolves. In that turnstile, author during his young age keep on swing on it until he was quite dizzy. Now author sees the turnstile was not there. Instead, open wall was replaced in that place where turnstile was located during his young age. Now hollyhocks was grown all over the wall. Hollyhocks means it's a tall Eurasian plant. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. What are you looking at? It was a disembodied voice at first. Moment later, a girl stood framed between dark red hollyhocks staring at the men. She was only 12 or 13 with lively eyes and long black hair. "I'm looking at the house. Is it yours?" he asked. "No, it's my father's. Why do you want to buy it?" "And what does your father do?" "He's only a colonel." "Only a colonel? Well, he should have been a brigadier by now." The man burst out laughing. "It's not funny," she says. Even mommy says he should be in a brigadier." It was on the tip of his tongue to make a witty remark. Perhaps that's why he's still a colonel. But he did not want to give offense. They stood on either side of the wall, appraising each other. "Do you want to buy it?" "No," he said. "Well," she said, "if you don't want to buy the house, what are you looking at?" "I used to live here 25 years ago as a boy, as a young man, and then my grandmother died and we sold the house and went." Now let's see the hard word. Colonel. Colonel means a rank of officer in the army. A rank of officer in the army. Then brigadier. Brigadier means a rank of officer in the British Army. It's above colonel position. It's above colonel position. Now I'll explain. Here the author is staring at the place. Suddenly he hears a voice. Then he just slowly turned towards the place where the voices came from. It was a small girl with beautiful eyes and long hair. She asked the author, "What are you looking at?" The author replied, "He is just looking at the house. Is it yours?" he asked. The little girl said, "No, it's my father's house." She added, "Why do you want to buy it?" Then author asked, "What does your father do?" The girl replied, "He is a colonel." As I said, colonel means a rank of officer in army. The author said, "Well, he should be brigadier by now." As I said, brigadier means it's a position above colonel. After saying this, the author began to laugh. Immediately, the girl replied, "It's not funny. Even mummy says he should be in a brigadier. But his tongue makes a witty remarks. That's why he still remains as a colonel in army. But he'll not cause any offense to anyone." Then the girl adds, "Do you want to buy it?" The author says, "No." Then the little girl cleverly asked, "If you don't want to buy the house, then why are you looking at?" The author replied, 25 years ago, I lived here as a young boy." And he also added, "We sold this house after my grandmother's death." Now let's move on to the next paragraph. She was silent for a while, taking in this information. Then she said, "And you'd like to buy it back now? But you don't have the money." He did not look very prosperous. I'll explain. The girl observed the author carefully and asked, "You like to buy it back now?" And she added, "But you don't have money, because the author looked not prosperous, that is rich." So the girl was in doubt whether the author came to buy or stay. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. "No, I was not thinking of buying it back, want to see it again, that's all." "How long have you lived in it?" "Only 3 years," she smiled. "Would you like to come in and look more closely?" "Won't your parents mind?" "They have gone to the club. They won't mind. I'm allowed to bring my friends home. Even elderly friends like me." "How old are you?" "Let me explain." The author replied, "No, I was not thinking of buying, just simply seeing it, that's it." The author asked the girl, "How long have you lived in it?" The girl replied, "Only 3 years." Then she adds, "Would you like to come in?" The author curiously asked, Won't your parents mind? The girl replied, "They've gone to club, so they won't mind to bring my friends home." The author curiously said, "Even elderly friends like me?" The girl immediately asked, "How old are you?" Now let's move on to the next paragraph. "Oh, just middle-aged, but feeling young today." And to prove it, he decided he'd climb over the wall instead of going round the gate. He got up on the wall all right, but had to rest there, breathing heavily. "Middle-aged man on the flying trapeze," he muttered to himself. "I'll help you," she said, and gave him her hand. He slithered down into a flower bed, shattering the stem of a hollyhock. Let's see the meaning. Trapeze. The word trapeze means it's an equipment used by an acrobat in circus. Now let's see the next word, muttered. Muttered means a word in a very low tone. Next, slithered. Slithered means it's a slide. The slide of a surface. Now I'll explain. The author replied to the girl, "I am a middle-aged man, but feeling very young today." To prove it, he decided to climb over the wall instead of going around the gate. Immediately, he got up on the wall and took heavy breath and think middle-aged man on the flying trapeze. He said to himself. Immediately, the girl said, "I'll help you," and gave her hand to the author to get down. While he was down, he slightly slipped and broken the stem of a hollyhock. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. As they walked across the grass, he spotted a stone bench under a mango tree. It was the bench on which his grandmother used to rest when she was tired of pruning rose bushes and bougainvillea. "Let's just sit here," he said. "I don't want to go inside." She sat beside him on the bench. Let's see the meaning for hard words. Pruning. The word pruning means the act of trimming. Bougainvillea. The word bougainvillea means trimming climbing plants. I'll explain the paragraph. Here, the author and the girl was walking across the grass. Suddenly, the author saw a bench under a mango tree. Immediately, he remembered his grandmother will take rest after trimming rose bushes and trimming climbing plants. After seeing the stone bench under the mango tree, the author said, "Let's just sit here." And he adds, "I don't want to go inside." Immediately, the girl also sit beside the author. Now, let's move on to the next paragraph. They were silent for some time. The man closed his eyes and remembered other times. The music of the piano, the chiming of a grandfather clock, the constant twitter of bajirigas on the veranda, his grandfather cranking up the old car. "I used to climb the jackfruit tree," he said, opening his eyes. Let's see the meaning for hard word,
The word chiming means melodious sound. Melodious sound. Next, budgerigars. The word budgerigars means a small Australian bird. A small Australian bird. This bird comes under a parrot species. Next, cranking. The word cranking means act of turning. Act of turning up something. Now I'll explain the paragraph. The author sat in silence and closed his eyes and thinking of the melodious music which his grandfather used to play. And then he remembered the constant twitter of Australian birds on the veranda. And also he remembered his grandfather turning up the old car to start. Suddenly, the author opened his eyes and said to the girl, he used to climb the jackfruit tree. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. Do you want to climb it again? My parents won't mind. No, no, not after climbing the garden wall. Let's just sit here for a few minutes and talk. I mentioned the jackfruit tree because it was my favorite place. Do you see that thick branch stretching out over the roof? Halfway along it, there's a small hollow in which I used to keep some of my treasures. What kind of treasure? I'll explain. Here, the girl asked, do you want to climb again? The author replied, no. After climbing the wall and broken some plant, I'm not ready to climb again. He adds, let's sit here for a moment, cause it's my favorite place. Then he asked the girl to see a particular thick branch which was over the roof of the house and he said there was a small hollow in which I used to keep my childhood treasure. The little girl curiously asked what kind of treasure. Let's move on to the next paragraph. Oh, nothing very valuable. Marbles I won, a book I was not supposed to read, a few old coins I collected. Things came and went. I was a bit of a crow, you know, collecting bright things and putting them away. There was my grandfather's iron cross. Well, not my grandfather's exactly, because he was British and the iron cross was a German decoration awarded for bravery during the war, the First World War. When my grandfather fought in France, he got it from a German soldier. I'll explain. Here the author replies to the girl, nothing very valuable. I'll treasurize some of the marbles I won, the book I never want to read, some old coins I collected, and also I kept my grandfather's iron cross, which was awarded for the bravery of my grandfather during the First World War. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. Do you still have it? No, he said, looking her in the eyes. I left it in the jackfruit tree. You left it in the jackfruit tree? Yes. I was so excited at the time, packing and saying goodbye to people and thinking about the ship I was going to sail on that I simply forgot all about it. I'll explain. The girl asked, do you still have the cross medal? The author replied, no, looking her in the eyes and said, I left it in the jackfruit tree. The girl again confirmed by asking, you left it in the jackfruit tree? The author said, yes, cause he was so excited about the packing and saying goodbye to the people he knows and also very much excited about the ship that he's going to sail. So he completely forgotten the medal. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. She quietly said, it may still be there in the hollow part of the branch. Yes, he said. It's 25 years, but it may still be there unless someone else found it. Would you like to go and look? I can't climb trees anymore. If you can't, I will go and see. You just sit here and wait for me. I found it, she cried. I found something. I'll explain. The girl quietly said, it may be there in the branches. The author replied, if none has taken means, then it will sure be there for past 25 years. Immediately, the girl enthusiastically asked, would you like to go and see? The author replied, I can't climb trees anymore. Immediately the girl replied, I'll go and see. You'll sit here and wait for me. Then within few minutes she shouted from the tree and said, I found it. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. And now barefoot, she ran breathlessly towards him, in her outstretched hand a rusty old medal. He took it from her and turned it over on his palm. Is it the Iron Cross? She asked eagerly. Yes, he said, this is it. Let me explain. The little girl ran breathlessly towards the author with bare foot and showed the old rusty medal. The author took it from her and saw. Then the little girl eagerly asked, is it the Iron Cross you missed? The author replied, yes. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. Now I know why you came. You wanted to see if it was still in the tree. You may be right. I'm not really sure why I came. But you can keep the cross. You found it after all. No, you keep it. It's yours. But it could have remained in the tree for another 25 years if you had not climbed up to look for it. I'll explain. The girl says to the author, now I found why you came. You came here to check whether the medal was in the tree or not. The author replied, you may be right. But I'm not sure why I came. And also, he gave the cross to the girl and says, you find it out after all. So, you keep it. The girl said, no, you keep it. It's yours. The author said, if you don't take it, it will be there in the tree for another 25 years. So, you keep it. So, the author hand over the cross medal to the girl. Now, let's move on to the next paragraph. She didn't understand that. But she walked with him to the gate and waited. Where the road turned, he looked back and waved to her. Then he quickened his step and moved briskly towards the bus stop. There was sprightliness in his step and something cried aloud in his heart. I'll explain. The little girl didn't understand anything what the author says, but she keep on walk along with the author till the gate. Then the author moves towards his way. He looked back and waved to her. Then he quickened his steps and moved towards the bus stop and feel the cry in his heart that he lost his youth days. Now let's move on to the next paragraph. The mango-scented summer breeze made the blood course in his vein and he forgot for a moment that he could not climb trees anymore. I'll explain. While Arthur standing in the bus stop, he feels the smell of the ripe mangoes in his blood course. He feels like eating for a moment. In that pleasant smell, he forgotten that he could not climb trees anymore. That's the end of the prose. In this we saw, Arthur is searching for his childhood memories by going back to the place where he lost. But finally, author comes to a conclusion that lost days is lost forever. I hope you all enjoy this prose. God has blessed you with youthful days. Try to enjoy and store pleasant memories in these days. Try to plant a tree, or if you don't have much space means at least try to plant a small plant. As an author's grandmother says, blessings will rest on the house where the shadow of a tree or plant falls. When you grow into an adult, these youthful memories will delight your mind. Okay, students, until we see again in next class, try to read this prose by your own. Meet you all in next class. Be safe and learn happily at home. Thank you.